For the first time ever, the Worldwide LRs return on Global Early. But who should you choose with your hard-earned red coins? How's it, everybody? Celtic Link here. We're back for another Dokkan Battle video. In today's video, we are taking a look at the units that are available with red coins on the current Dokkan Festival banner for the Super Saiyan Rose. This is the first time ever on Global Dokkan that a worldwide anniversary LR has returned before the anniversary. So the question is, are either one of these still worth your hard-earned red coins? And if so, which ones should you choose? So first off, let's take a look at what all is available on the banner for red coins. So because this is a red coin, this is a Dokkan Fest banner, all units that are Dokkan Fest on the banner can be purchased with red coins. So this time around, we got the AGL Vegeta and Goku, we have the Tech Zamasu, we have the Int Vegeta and Trunks, the Future Gohan, and the Tech Trunks. All four of these units can be purchased with red coins. Everything else cannot be because they are either banner units or they are the brand new unit itself. So that begs the question, out of the available units, which of the two LRs is worth your coins? So let's take a look at the Vegito here. So Vegito is Battle of Fate Future Saga, and Power Beyond Super Saiyan, Category Ki 3, HP, Attack, and Defense, 170%. He also gives an additional 30% to Realm of Gods or Time Travelers. Now, they have an interesting sub-leader skill here of giving super class characters a 150 lead. So that is a really, really interesting leader skill. It's very, very helpful on oh so many setups to have just any random character be on the 50% lead there, the 150% lead. So very, very helpful, right? It allows you to run things like LR Bulma on this team, even though she's only on the 150 because her damage reduction is so high. It does allow you to still get the buff from her, since she can kind of handle things even on a 150. So very, very nice having that leader skill. Now, they do raise attack infinitely on their 12 key and raise defense infinitely on their 18 key. They have an entrance animation that activates once only. It gives them defense 100% and guards all attacks for 4 turns from the start of turn when there's another Future Saga ally on the team at the start of the attacking turn. They get key 3 and attack and defense 100%, and additional key 1, key 2 per type keys for obtain, and an additional attack and defense 150%, and attacks effective against all types when there's a Realm of Gods category enemy. They have an additional 150% and high chance of evading enemy's attack, including super attack, as the first attacker in the turn. They have an additional attack 100% and defense 50%, and launch an additional attack. This is a high chance of becoming a super attack as the second or third attacker in the turn. They launch an additional super attack when key is 20 or more. They can transform into Vegito Blue when HP is 70% or less from the fifth turn from the start of turn, or when there's another Future Saga ally attacking in the same turn, or Future Saga enemy starting from the seventh turn with no HP restrictions. So very, very, it's not difficult to activate, but it can be a bit of a pain depending on the boss you're fighting and whether or not you take the right amount of damage. So realistically, what you're doing with these guys in their base is doing your best to get them to not only stack defense on their 18 key, but get as many extra additional supers as they can with their 12 key, so they can carry over that attack raise into their next form as Vegito Blue. Speaking of Vegito Blue, once transformed, they actually become one of the best units in the game. Now they are greatly raising attack and defense for the turn on their 18 key, along with giving super class allies an extra 50% defensive buff on their super attack multiplier. So very, very nice there. They also greatly raise attack and defense for the turn on the 12 key while lowering the enemy attack and defense. So once they are transformed, they have a lot going on for them, right? Their passive gives them key 5 attack defense, 250%, an additional 2 key per key sphere obtained. They have effect against all types. They reduce damage received by 30% before attacking and reduce damage received by 20%. So it's a 50% damage reduction. They have a high chance of evading enemy's attack, including super attacks, and they launch an additional attack that has a high chance of becoming a super attack as the first attacker in the turn. They also launch an additional super attack that has a medium chance of launching another additional super attack as the second or third attacker in a turn. They launch an additional super attack when activating the active skill or when key is 20 or more. So their active skill causes ultimate damage and gives them guaranteed evasion for the turn that it is activated, and it can be activated when either their HP is 50% or less or your HP is 50% or less. So very, very nice there. So basically the strategy with this guy is get to that transformation turn, get that active skill off, dodge everything for a free turn of not getting hit, and launch upwards of 6 super attacks, right? He can do 6 super attacks if all goes well. So that ends up being a lot of damage, especially if he ends up getting those extra supers in the base form to raise that attack. So honestly, looking at everything he's doing and how useful he is for the teams that he is on, honestly, he's definitely worth it, right? He is definitely worth your 500 coins. And again, this is something we've been asking for oh so very long on Global, was a chance to pick these guys up earlier than the anniversary, right? In years past, the worldwide LRs only ever returned on anniversary, which means for Global, we basically had to wait an entire year to pick up a worldwide unit if we missed. So having the ability to do this now in February, March timeframe is very, very nice, and it's definitely worth it. You can easily build back up coins by the time anniversary rolls back around to make up for the purchase you made here, and Vegito is definitely worth it. He's a very, very powerful card. I know a lot of people are saying he aged out because of the anniversary units, and I just don't think that that's true. I feel that he only got better. His best partner is the Fizz Gogeta Blue, and they rock together. It is pretty amazing what they can do together on a team. So he is definitely worth the 500 coins. So now the question is his counterpart, the Texamos, still worth the coins? Texamos is Realm of Gods, Worldwide Chaos, and Fused Fighters, 170%, with an additional for Time Travelers and Final Trump card on the 30%. Now, just like the Vegito does for Superclass, he does for Extreme Class, putting them on the 150 lead. So very, very helpful. There's a lot of neat shenanigans you can pull with that, right? Running characters like Chi-Lai on the lead to give some extra support, or Broly Trio, for example, for some support and some dodging shenanigans. Right? There's a lot you can do there. On his 18 key, he is massively raising his attack and raising defense for the turn while greatly lowering the enemy's attack. On his 12 key, he is greatly raising attack and defense for the turn, causing colossal damage and greatly lowering defense. On his passive, he is activating an instant animation and reducing damage received by 20% for 4 turns from the start of turn, plus an additional 20% for the first turn. So he has 40% damage reduction on that first turn. When there's another Realm of Gods category ally on the team at the start of his attacking turn, he also gets key 6 and attack and defense 100%, and an additional key 3 and attack and defense 50% when there are no Realm of Gods category enemies. He has a high chance of performing a critical hit and reduces damage received by 40%. He has an additional defense 50% when receiving an attack, and if HP is 70% or less when receiving an attack. He's an additional defense 50% and launches an additional attack that has a 50% chance of becoming a super attack within the same turn after receiving an attack, and he has an additional 25% with each attack received. So ideally with this guy, you want to put him in slot one for the first couple of turns and let that build, all right? Because while he does have 40% damage reduction on that first turn, he ends up having 60, but once those four turns is up and he only has the 40, he can be a bit squishy in some of the later portions of the fight, right? But it's nice that his best partner can kind of make up for that loss of slot one to him very, very easily. Now, he does have an active skill that creates a domain and raises extreme allies key by 3 and becomes omnipresent. Basically means he cannot be hit for 5 turns. It can be activated when 70% or less from the 5th turn from the start of turn, when there's another Future Saga ally attacking in the same turn, or Future Saga enemy starting from the 7th turn. So basically the same as Vegito's, although when you're running this guy, you basically guaranteed to have a Future Saga ally. So it's not that hard to do with this team. Once he goes into his domain and becomes the Infinite Zamas, he now is massively raising the attack for the turn on his 18 key and greatly raising it on the 12 key. Now, he basically cannot be attacked, right? He nullifies all attacks directed at him, whether it's normals or supers, and gets 300% attack and changes AGL and STR to tech key spheres, while also giving Worldwide Chaos allies 60% with 4 or more key spheres obtained. So you want to really push those tech key spheres with this guy. Now, the domain, when active, increases damage received by superclass enemies and allies by 30%. So it allows the team to hit a little bit harder since they are losing this big hitter once the domain goes active. So again, he has a very, very valuable domain skill. And I know domains, especially on the extreme side, are getting a little saturated, especially now with the 9th anniversary in play. But it's still a very, very useful skill, right? The ability to just create a guaranteed slot one, no damage character for you while you let your slot two and slot three units do their thing is very, very helpful. He is very good for that. And even then, in his base form, very good. He's basically got 4 turns of little to no damage, right? When he's in this form with all of that, damage reduction going on and the attack defense building that he's doing, you end up with a very, very powerful card. And I have personally attested to more dupes in him, the better, right? He is definitely working much better for me now with 79% than he was before with the 55%. So that is definitely a plus for him. So looking at that, I would say he is definitely worth the coins, right? Both of these cards, returning early is a very good thing for global players, and they are both extremely worth your 500 coins. While they may not be the best in the game compared to what's on JP currently, for a global player, they're going to be very, very useful until then. And even then, post anniversary, they're still going to be helpful on those teams introduced during the anniversary. So you won't lose anything by grabbing them now. If anything, they'll only get better with time. Now, with that in mind, if you had to pick one, which one would you pick? Personally, I think Vegito Blue is the better choice of the two for the longevity. He's going to provide much more for the teams that he is on. He's got, being a Pure Saiyan, being a Goku and Vegeta unit, there's a lot of places he can slot into and provide that Vegito cover, right? Versus Zamas here, who basically can only be run on one team. And it's not a bad team. It's a good team, don't get me wrong. It's just not as versatile. He's going to, until Broly comes out, he's only got basically his own team. And even then, the version of Broly's team with him on it is still pretty similar, right? You're running a lot of the same units anyways. So honestly, Vegito, for the time being, I would rank him as your number one choice, with this guy being your number two. But obviously go with whichever one you're missing. missing. Now, some considerations before you chuck 500 Cored coins at it is characters you may need in the future, right? If you're someone who missed out on full power Super Saiyan 4 Goku during the Tanabata thank you celebration back in November, this guy will be returning in about a month on March 18th, and this will be our first chance to pick him up. So if you missed him, just understand that, or maybe you got shafted, right? Understand that the loss here in 500 coins is a loss on being able to pick him up. Well, it's not really a loss, but if you use your coins, you're losing your chance to pick this guy up in the future. Another consideration might be, right, maybe you want to save for the anniversary LRs. You're worried you might get shafted during the anniversary. All right, you might not be able to save enough stones in time, so you just want to make sure you have coins on the back end. Just know that if that is your plan, that you have at least 1,000 coins saved up and start saving now. But it's something to consider. The Beast Gohan and the Broly are some of the best cards in the game on JP right now, and if you want to just make sure you have those in your back pocket in case things go wrong, definitely not a bad deal. One other thing to consider is if you skipped out on the Goku Black Rosé, you may want to consider saving a couple coins for him, as we don't know when his return could be, and it could be on one of those banners that maybe it's not such a good idea to be summoning on, right? Like with the situation with God Goku. So it might be worth keeping 400 coins in your back pocket to pick this guy up when he does finally return on Global. So guys, that is it for our video. If you liked our video, make sure you hit that like button and subscribe to the channel if you have not already. And in the comments down below, let me know, who did you end up grabbing with your red coins? Did you grab Zamas? Did you grab the blue boys? Or was there somebody else you're waiting to use your coins on? Let me know in the comments down below. Otherwise, guys, as always, thanks for watching. And aloha.